Dolores, thank you very much. And I tell you what, are you folks ready to elect a new president this year? I thought I knew the answer to that question, and I have invited all four of the major candidates to come here to North Dakota and tell us what they have to say about becoming President of the United States. We are delighted today to have one of those four candidates, Ron Paul, here to speak to us.
Yeah!
Yeah, okay. Let me just say, Congressman Paul, we feel that North Dakota is a blueprint for what the country should be doing right now. We've got a balanced budget. We've had a surplus of each of the last 4 years. We think that we keep our house in order in North Dakota. And if the nation would do that, we would all be in great shape.
That's right.
We also know... We also know that this administration has got their EPA and other agencies harassing our agriculture, harassing our energy industries, and all of these things have got to stop absolutely as soon as possible.
That's right.
Dr. Paul, please come forward. We're glad to have you in North Dakota.
And well received. I want to introduce my wife. I've been married to her for 55 years. We have 18 grandchildren. We only got one to come with us today. This is Linda, one of the 18. But it is great to be here. The one thing that I do know is that in this state, people are very friendly. And they're very much oriented, even from the short meeting that you've had so far, very much oriented to limited government and more freedom, and that's what we need. Of course, we are involved. We are very much involved in election, and I hope those individuals who are in District 12 will hang around and participate in the delegate process. That would be helpful to pursue getting our delegates elected. But I do want to thank the governor and all of you who were able to get our schedule arranged so that we could come by and visit you today. But, you know, we do face a lot of problems. And no matter where I go, though the economy is doing well here, there's always the threat hanging over our heads no matter where we are. What are the feds going to do to us? Are they going to overtax us, overregulate us? Are they going to destroy the economy with bubbles and a very deeply flawed monetary policy which affects all of us? And the one reason why I think we should be looking at monetary policy, addressing the subject of bad money, and looking at the Federal Reserve and find out why they are causing way too much mischief. Eventually, we're going to have monetary reform just because this is a system that will not prevail. Now, others who are very much in the establishment and the internationalists know this to be the case, and they are laying plans. But guess where they are laying plans for a new monetary system, financial system? Under the United Nations, and that is what we have to prevent. We need monetary reform, but it should be here under our national sovereignty.
Yeah, right.
Couple days being here, the subject of property rights comes up. Obviously, property rights is the basis of a free market system. But we've gotten to the point where we don't really have ownership of our property. Of course, we're taxed on the property, and then we're regulated at all levels. But the one thing is, if you have to have regulations, they have to be local. They should not be from the federal government. The Constitution... Let me tell you, the founders didn't give us explicit authority to have an EPA. They probably would be shocked if they knew of agencies of government like the EPA. I'll tell you, the fact that property is very important, environment is very important, it doesn't mean in private property ownership that we ignore our neighbors. It means we handle our problems differently. And if you look at history, property and the environment is much better protected under private hands than it is under government hands. There's no proof that government ownership and government regulations does very much. Just look at the 20th century, the totalitarian society, the Soviet system, and social, they don't have better control of the environment. It's people who own the land and local government that should be responsible for the environment, and if there's to be regulations, they should all be local. Of course, I've campaigned on the various issues, and which we do not have time now, but one has been the monetary policy, one is the free market, the debt is a big, big burden. That's why I'm proposing that we cut $1 trillion out of the first year's budget to get back on balance. Of course, personal liberty is the essence of all that we desire, and liberty means personal liberty and economic liberty. But it's out of control now. Personal liberty is not well defended. The government now is too secret, and the people's privacy has been destroyed. The government was supposed to be there to protect our privacy. The government is supposed to be open and not secret. This assumption that government can regulate us and protect us against ourselves has led to way too much interference in our lives. For instance, in agriculture, you know, our American tradition has been around for a long time, and there was a certain substance that was allowed to be raised, and probably not too far from here, it was traditional. There is no reason in a free society that farmers shouldn't be allowed to raise hemp. There is no reason that hemp is a good product. Also in a free society, farmers ought to be allowed to sell raw milk, you know. The most important thing is getting our budget in order, but I do believe that can't happen unless we have a different foreign policy. This foreign policy of intervention and occupation is not what the founders gave us. We don't have the moral authority, we don't have the legal authority to be occupying lands and practicing preventive war, preemptive war. We are overseas now in over 900 bases, 130 countries. In the last 10 years, our efforts overseas has added $4 trillion to our national debt. Think how much wealthier this country would have been if we had not spent that money. And there was one way that could have been prevented. Had only people in Washington that would insist that we only go to war if there's a declaration of war in our national defense, fight the wars, win them, and come home and not have these perpetual no-win unconstitutional wars. The wonderful part about this is the answers aren't too difficult. We are in trouble because we drifted from the original intent of the Constitution, the original notion that liberty enhances the middle class, it creates the largest and the richest middle class. The middle class is getting smaller right now, and it's getting much poorer. We have a system that serves the interests of the powerful and the special interests, the wealthy. They make money when the bubble is being formed under the monetary policy of the Federal Reserve. But guess what? When the bubbles burst, guess who gets bailed out? The people who have been making all the money. And what happens to the bad debt? Gets dumped on the American people. Right now, our government, especially the Federal Reserve, is planning to bail out Europe and the banks of Europe and bail out all the banks that bought all this Greek debt and Spanish debt. It's being dumped on us. It cannot be sustained. This is why we need the reforms. We need to defend liberty. We have to realize that liberty will bring all people together. And this is why the message of liberty is very broad-based. It's not designed for Republicans, and it's not designed for Democrats. It's designed for the American people. If we truly understand what personal liberty is and how it comes from our Creator and how our liberties and our lives come from our Creator, it should and can bring all of us together for us to once again understand that the American dream is alive and well. Thank you very much for coming today.
Some of the introductions, acknowledgments, out of the way now between now and 1:30 before the convention starts because of the weather and the number of people that are here today. So with that thought in mind, we are going to, I'm going to give them is District.
Shane? Okay.
Well, what an awesome...
Texas Congressman and Republican presidential hopeful Ron Paul included Jamestown in his North Dakota stops on Monday afternoon, February 20th, 2012, at the Knights of Columbus Hall in Jamestown. Paul addressed a large gathering of supporters and local GOP delegates that were elected at the district convention, also being held at the Knights of Columbus Hall. The delegates will represent the district at the GOP nominating convention in March in Bismarck. Among the issues addressed by Congressman Paul, he emphasized personal freedom and limited government, and he pointed out problems facing America, including overtaxing, overregulation, and a flawed U.S. monetary policy. And he called for the United States to enact monetary reform.
And no matter where I go, though the economy is doing well here, there's always the threat hanging over our heads no matter where we are. What are the feds going to do to us? Are they going to overtax us, overregulate us? Are they going to destroy the economy with bubbles and a very deeply flawed monetary policy which affects all of us? And the one reason why I think we should be looking at monetary policy, addressing the subject of bad money, and looking at the Federal Reserve and find out why they are causing way too much mischief.
Also on hand to greet Paul in Jamestown on Monday was North Dakota Governor Jack Dalrymple. He told the gathering that he was pleased that Congressman Paul took the time to visit North Dakota. The governor said he's invited all four quote-unquote major Republican candidates running for the presidential nomination to North Dakota. The governor added that it is critical that leaders on a national level take a look at what we are doing right here in North Dakota because it works.
Well, we're very pleased to welcome all of our presidential candidates to North Dakota. Today it's Ron Paul. I've invited all four of the major candidates on the Republican side, and I hope they will all come to North Dakota. We enjoy telling these national candidates what a great thing we have going in North Dakota. We ask them to look at North Dakota as a blueprint for what the nation can become. If all 50 states were doing things the way North Dakota is doing them, I think our country would be in wonderful shape. So it's a great occasion. A lot of people showed up here today in Jamestown, and I think the enthusiasm is extremely high.
Said North Dakota can be a blueprint for the rest of the nation to follow. And he added North Dakota's methods for success are no secret. And he said, quote, we welcome everyone across the country to join us and move America forward, end quote. Reporting for KCSI TV News, this is Wayne Byers.